The idea of today's class is to basically look into what how a blocking exercise is eventually executed, and we're going to see the preview of what you've done. Okay. So just to have everybody's attention and to put everybody in one page, the idea, the reason why we did blocking exercise. Okay. Now, although you made a short film last semester, okay, but it is very rare to actually work on an adapted screenplay. Like for example, if I give you a screenplay already, okay, and the screenplay is like the final screenplay, because I actually picked up like a real film screenplay and I give it to you. So which means that it does not have those errors, or it does not have any other further changes that it can possibly have. And maybe if you've seen the film, you've already seen the scene already. In fact, I think I've played the scene for you, right? Yeah. So you're already aware of how it's been shot. Okay. Now when you get something like that and you get the freedom to tweak it, when I say tweaking it, I'm hoping that you followed my instruction where you can change the dialogue. But the main motivation of the scene should not change. The main motivation of the scene, if you remember the logline, was about how two people meet each other. It could be the circumstance around them, but they were not destined to meet this, but they met. Right? They met because of their certain conditions and certain situations. That was the main motivation of the scene. Okay. So I give you the screenplay. Now, what do you do after you get the screenplay? Because, and again, from your team, I choose strictly directors because I want it to be completely director-driven. In a way that the director gets it, the screenplay. And obviously, I've also given you who is a camera person, who is a sound recordist, and all of that. Right? Although it was not really, really clear in the beginning, but somewhere in the middle, you got to know who you'll be working in, what each person's role play will be. So, from the planning point of view, once you are a director and you've got the script, the screenplay, then how do you go about it? The first thing that you obviously would do is that you have to look at the screenplay and see if there's any changes you want to make, which you did. Right? After the changes were made, you have to just discuss that screenplay with your team. Okay? And if you are somebody who's like really independent, you do all the homework, you come back and you brief your team. Or you can work in a very organic way, which is like, you work with your team and then you have discussion and then you go back and then work and come back. So you get the suggestions from your team members and you come back and say, okay, this is how I've imagined the scene. Just basically hear me out. This is how I have broken down the screenplay. So that's what we call as a standard short division. Yeah. So you can do the short division in table format later. But ideally, the first place you should continue to start working is the screenplay on the paper itself. That's what we mean by script marking. You mark the script. Now this marking might be different when the shooting is happening. But this is what you intend to do. When you're on the field, things can happen, things can go wrong. Some bright ideas might come to one of our team members. You might also get excited with that. You might change it. But to begin with, you should start with the script marking. So that you have an overall idea. Okay, I'm going to cover this thing. I want to have a camera movement like this. Okay. After you line the script, then you should actually sit with the camera person and look at the end, finally, and finalize the location. Because the moment you go to location, you know what your lighting source is going to be. Because sitting here, without going to your real location, you can't say what lighting you're going to get. You can't say, I'm going to put these two lights here, I'm going to move the camera from here to here. It all might sound great, but once you reach a location, like I wanted to go to each one of your shoots, but I went to one shoot. And it was quite cramped. There were a lot of chairs. I went to that, I went to Ashton's shoot. It was quite cramped. I was sitting in one corner. I could see how difficult for you was to basically maneuver and put your camera positions, because you didn't have an empty floor. You already had furniture in place. Yeah. And the more you were moving things around, the more you were giving discomfort to the owner and the person, because they didn't anticipate. You don't anticipate this kind of things. Yeah? They have no idea how much camera you will bring, how much crew you will bring, how much lights you will bring, that you will hold the entire shop for ransom. It's almost like that. So I saw how you guys were working, and although Ashton seemed to be in good control, I could see that he knew what's happening next. I was asking him to fish some information out. But then yeah, it seemed like, I just want to see how much control the director has over the proceedings. Okay. So once you reach the location, so that location, for example, I would have actually opened those shades a little bit. It would have given you a nice pattern.
I don't know. Blinders or?
Yeah, a little bit. And yeah, it would have made your lighting more complicated. But say for example, if you had thought about it, or you have thought about the space, you know, you could have actually had a better, you could have reached there, like barricaded the place, in a sense like emptied the place, like or made like a imaginary gap where you know that this is excess, you will not cross like this, you know, that way. So you should have like a floor plan, that's very important. After you line your script, then you check the location, you should come back and have a floor plan, because now you know where the furnitures are, where there's a plant, where there's a window. And then the camera person can also have like a planning as far as lighting and lighting equipment is concerned. You should know key in the floor plan, where is your key lines going to come from. That should be the planning. You can't do this on the field. Okay, that's going to be very, very bad if you do it on the field. It should be actually on the paper. After you came back from location scouting, you should come back and make a floor plan, which includes the camera movement, the camera the camera position. So as per your shots, so in your shot division, no, you should have like a camera position column, and you should point the camera position and like, you know, draw a dot. And I showed you in that lecture where I showed you the different softwares available where you can actually do this very easily, where you can actually draw furnitures also, and you have a very good idea where the character is going to be placed. See, all in all, you might feel I'm very confident. I don't have to do all this. I know exactly the place how it is. That's great. I mean, I'm not saying lots of directors do not do that. There are a lot of directors who do not carry anything on paper. Okay, but I don't want you to be like those directors. At least, you know, in the beginning when you're learning things, should be more. And see, it's all also communication. Your team would be knowing better. Your camera team will know better. That you know, okay, what's the next shot? Next shot is shot number 5. Okay. So they can refer, they also should have a paper. They can refer to the shot number 5 and see camera position this. And they can check the floor plan with camera position this. They will not ask you. They will just go and place the camera. You are not bothered. Right? You are not bothered. Okay, you are in a wrong place, you know, move here, move there. You're wasting less time in your instruction. I want the directors to be spending more time looking into the acting performance after the take, go in a huddle with your assistant director, you know, and then check the shot. Let nobody else bother. And as I mentioned, it's always nice as a director to have a chat with your cast in the location, only the cast. With nobody else around. You can tell your rest of the team to go and take a break, go for a smoke break, or whatever. Tea break, coffee break, you know, go. Let me be with my cast, and let me just brief my cast. I said, you know, this is the location. So that you get them into that particular rhythm. So they're listening to you, they're paying attention to you. When the actors are there, if they're professionals, they will pay attention. If they're not professional, they will get distracted. That distraction can be very bad for you. So that's one. So that paper, that planning, so you want to have the floor plan, okay? Then you discuss with your team and then you figure out what you want, how do you want to do it, okay? Which, and then one step I did not teach you, which I have to teach you later, which is called script breakdown. You had some props there, then, books and all.
Books and all, yeah.
Did you get all the props that you needed, and who did that work of getting the props or finding out where to get the props from, who will get the props from? Who did that? You were bringing what role? Okay, so you took care of the props. So you look at the screenplay and you do a breakdown. Okay, you look at the cast. In each shot, you need 2 actors, 1 actors. How many extras? Now, there's a video. I'll share this link with you. You can watch it. And it's very, very well explained how to do a script breakdown from the screenplay. So as a director or assistant director, you have to do a script breakdown. You have to read the screenplay and mark. So you say an actor with a hat walks in, you underline the hat. That's a prop. Yeah? So for example, anything, and then extras. Often you forget extras. How many extras do you need? Right? Now if I had been in your place, I would have actually deliberately kept one person serving behind from a cast. So you need to have cast, extras, props, costumes, all this you underline in the screenplay. And then you make a column and then you keep writing what all you need, what all you require for each shot. Makeup, vehicles, stunts, any kind of sound effects that you need to recreate later. Now you should ideally, I don't know, I haven't seen your edit yet, but you should ideally have a soundscape of a little less busy cafe, where you have faint sound of the coffee machine. You should have it.
I'm getting there.
See, this is what happens, it brings the audience immediately into that location.
Immersion.
Yep.
Immersion.
So which means when you are in that location and you're shooting, you did not take any, I'm not saying you have to take, do a recording of that while you're shooting. I'm saying while you're doing the script breakdown, you should also think about the sound effects that you need for the scene, which you have to source. Got it? Then you have any kind of livestock, which is any kind of birds, animals involved in the, in the film. Okay. So you need to do a script breakdown. So I'll send you this link. So please, it's a very, very good resource. It has videos and it has exact things. Script breakdown you need to do. Script breakdown will help you in terms of planning well. Okay. And then you have to meet the cast one day, 2 days, 3 days. Depends upon how experienced your cast is. And after you met the cast, you should have like a conversation with them, telling them what is the motivation, how you want it to be. And you ask them, like, so what do you understand about your character? So let them do some thinking. Let them not just come there and say the dialogues. Let them just think about their character. I was really looking for a Charming, what Charming does. Okay. So they let them think about themselves as their character. Why are they there? Why are they in the cafe? What happens to them? Well, how is the character changing? Okay. So you need to tell from your point of view what you're expecting from them, because you might expect something, they might be thinking something else. So you need to sit at a table and discuss. Okay, so you're on the same page. Getting, so you want her to be faintly disappointed, but she shows you disappointment because she's thinking differently. Getting, so that conversation is very important. So all of you are in the same page. Yeah. So after you have that cast meeting, I mean, I didn't go through casting because casting again is a very, very specialized field. Not everybody can do a good job in casting. So casting is also quite important. But after you get the cast right, you have to discuss this with your cast, get things rolling, and then you finally reach the location. Okay. So once you find it, so imagine all this is pre-production. And how much value to pre-production will define how easy and smooth your shoot happens.